Hey, what's up everyone? This is Geronimo, the proud founder of ProsperityLifeFans.com. Today's episode is Lower Your Expectations. On this episode, we're going to be covering why it would be a good idea to lower your expectations. And this is a little contrasting to set big goals. Ideally, you're combining both. You have big goals, yet you have low expectations and realistical, almost like a step-by-step milestones that will help you arrive to that goal. A lot of people, when they set big goals, they get disappointed because what happens? After not getting what they want, the ego gets hurt, they get disappointed, and bad things happen in general. And this is because their expectations are not based on reality. Their expectation is, I want too much, too soon, too early, too fast, right now. And I know this because I'm in a similar boat myself, where, you know, I've been on the business grind for many years now. And at some point you kind of come to the conclusion that, alright, let's just do this how it needs to be. Whatever needs to happen is gonna happen. I'm gonna gradually build it up over time, and that's just how it's gonna happen. It's gonna be slow and steady wins the race. We're gonna be patient. Rushing to the finish line is not a really helpful strategy, because what happens when people try to rush? They get stressed out, they get worried, they get pressed. A lot of people, they actually rush to the finish line and they give up. They give up because their expectations are too much, too early. This is why beginners in any sort of category should really, really set their kind of bars more realistic. It's almost like if you're a beginner, you really should have beginner expectations. Or no expectations, rather. And some people, they set their sights up too high, so eager, and then they fall on their face and they get disappointed and they wonder why they fell down. And it hurts, and it's just like, ouch, 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 this hurts, this pains, this is so annoying, I don't want to do this anymore. And the thing is that they keep falling, face flat on the ground, and it's because their expectations is too high. As a beginner, you kind of just want to ease your way into it, and at the intermediate level, you kind of want to, like, you know, maybe spike it up, boost it up a little bit. The thing is, sometimes, like, when you know too much, too early, like, if you know the whole ins and outs of everything, your expectations is going to be a little skewed, a little kind of twisted right from the beginning, and this will kind of make it worse for you, because, in a sense, if you're a beginner, you really should just have moderate expectations and allow yourself to build up gradually into whatever it is, whatever goal you're trying to manifest. It's like if you're trying to get a six pack, realistically, you probably won't be getting it within a month. Now, I know for me, in a six pack, like, I got mine many years ago, so I don't have to work too hard to get a six pack. I just kind of maintain it. I don't know how long it took me to get a six pack. I just know at a teenage year, I was like, oh, hey, I want a six pack. That would be nice. Got a six pack, and now all I have to do is maintenance. But I don't remember how long it took me to get a six pack. But yeah, like, getting a six pack, I think it's supposed to take a while. I think it takes like a couple months, and that requires a big diet change, exercise, and oh my god, good supplements that are fat burning, supplements that aid you in burning fat, because that's essentially what getting a six pack is burning fat. It's a certain kind of body fat percentage. Alright, so when it comes to reaching your goals, you want to have low expectations. And even no expectations, rather. It's almost like you just want to go forward. Almost kind of like if you weren't even there. If you can kind of go forward, almost like you're not even there, that would be like the ideal situation. Now, this is a lot easier said in like theory than it's like it's done in practice. The theory is, it's like if you can just do the grind without almost like being there, like if you weren't there at all, that would be ideal. Because what kind of interrupts people from getting their goals is just the conscious mind, the ego, the process itself, they give up. In actuality, most goals are fairly simple. They're fairly simple. You want a six pack, you go to the gym. You want a business, you start up a business and you do the hustle, you do the grind, you find the traffic, you sell them products and services. You want a boyfriend or girlfriend, you play the numbers game, you improve on your skill sets. They're all really simple. It's simple, simple, simple. It's just that it takes a little bit of effort, and even a lot of effort. A lot of effort. In the beginning, when you're jumping into anything, I seriously recommend that you lower your expectations. Because by lowering your expectations, you'll get to a good kind of foot where it's like, okay, you know what? I'm not supposed to reach meet like be at a certain point. I'm not expecting these kind of results. I'm not expecting $1 million overnight. I'm not expecting to burn 20 pounds over one in one day. Those are unrealistic expectations. And then yet at the same time, you still want to maintain this kind of like, oh yes, that's this desire to reach the final outcome, the final goal. So it's why these things are a little complicated to explain, because it's like it's what you have to maintain it. You have to maintain these kind of mindsets while you're juggling many different things and many aspects in your life. That's why these things are really hard to explain. But it's not so black and white, it's not so simple. But in regards to goal setting and reaching your goals, if you're a beginner or even intermediate, it would be wise to just start small, start simple, build up, build up, build up. And even for me with prosperitylifehacks.com, where it was like, I already knew like a lot of these like tips and tricks and things, because I've been around online since I was like 8 years old. So I've been on the internet for like almost like 16 years now. So for me, it's like, yeah, I got this, I got this. And even then, I had to grind it out. I had to hustle. I had to do the trial and error. I had to do the trial and error just to get like in that rhythm of like, okay, yeah, I'm in this now. Because I had a lot of setbacks on my own when I was starting my own business, my website business. It was kind of annoying having to deal with these setbacks. Especially because when, for me, because like I know a lot of these things and I still have to go through these things too. Ironically enough, I still go through these same things myself. And this is probably why I know how to explain it best to people, because I can speak it in their language and they understand, because I go through the same things myself, or I've been out of it, got out of it. But the funny thing is that sometimes you're not always like fully out of it, because it's not like you win life and that's the end. It's not like in a video game where it's like you beat the final boss and that's it. There's nothing else to do. And you know what's cool? Like even in video games, like even when you beat the game, there's more things to do. In our reality, once you get all your goals fulfilled, then what? Once you materialize all your desires, then what? Well, you will have more desires to make up for it. Maybe you'll be helping other people get their own desires met. Maybe it'll be something else, maybe a bigger goal, maybe a big house, beautiful family, happy family, whatever. But the point is that our desires are never ending, and that is of God. That is part of our DNA, that is part of the thing to help us progress and expand and evolve. By the way, some of you guys why wonder why I do podcasts. It's particularly because my setup is not really good for video vlogs, and I don't really have a high quality vlogs. That's why I don't do camera so much, just in case you guys were wondering. So just to recap this quick video, lower your expectations. When you lower your expectations, you don't have any kind of quota to maintain. Just start at the very bare minimum and work your way up. If for example, you can't do 10 push-ups, why is your goal 20 push-ups? Your goal should simply just be, let's say 10 push-ups, and you start with one. If you can only do one, you do one, and then you move up the ladder, so to speak. That's just really how it works. It's like people can't do 10, but they want to do 100, and that's not the way it works. Because that's not based on reality. So I guess just to sum up this video, lower your expectation this way that you don't feel kind of bummed out by your results. And even for your, like, for you intermediates or advanced people, you know, maybe you need to backtrack a little bit and lower your expectations again. Maybe you skip too many steps and you might have to go back down a little bit, not just to kind of like lower it down, and just be practical. Anyways, guys, this is Geronimo, the proud founder of ProsperityLifeHacks.com. For more excellent, amazing tips and tricks like this one, please feel free to visit me down at ProsperityLifeHacks.com. Click the link down below and visit me there. I'll see you inside. Until next time, bye-bye now.